Hi, everybody. We're celebrating today. This is our 150th video. We like to celebrate every single day. So we are so excited for the celebration today. I'm gonna make some fancy schmancy foods today. We're gonna have apps and a cocktail. The apps that I'm gonna make two really fancy kinds of deviled eggs. One is a Caesar deviled egg and one is a Bloody Mary deviled egg. You know, I love deviled eggs. I think everybody does. And when I was younger, my kids were little, we'd be going to a party. People would ask, what are you bringing? And I'd say deviled eggs. And you know why? Because they were so inexpensive to make, but you could make them so fancy and people love deviled eggs. So for our Caesar deviled egg, we're gonna need some mayo and eggs, of course. We're gonna be using salt and pepper. We'll be using some Dijon mustard, one clove of garlic. We'll be using some grated Parmesan cheese and some lemon. Now for our Bloody Mary deviled eggs, of course we need our eggs and mayo. We're gonna use some pickles for garnishing. We're gonna need a little bit of celery seed. We're gonna use some horseradish. Ooh, that's gonna be so good. A little bit of tomato paste. We're gonna use some lemon. We're gonna need some Old Bay. And we're gonna use some of the toppings from your celery stalk, so make sure you save them. Let's get going. You know, friends, sometimes I've heard people saying they have a hard time making the perfect hard-boiled egg. Let me show you how I do mine.
To hard-boil a dozen eggs, I'm using a pot where the eggs just fit across the bottom, and I'm going to cover them with water. Making sure that the eggs are covered entirely in water, bring them to the stove top, put your cover on the pot, and turn your burner on high. Once the water comes to a boil, turn your heat down to simmer and leave the cover on 3/4 of the way for 10 minutes. After 10 minutes, just turn your burner off, put the cover on all the way, and you can let the eggs either sit for a while or you can take them right to the sink to rinse them in cold water. And they're ready to go. So the first thing I'm gonna do to get this started for my Caesar eggs, I wanna make these beautiful Parmesan crisps, just little ones to put on top of every egg. Wait till you see how gorgeous these are. My oven is set at 375. I've grated some Parmesan nice and fine. And I'm gonna take just a little bit of Parmesan and I'm making 12 of these Caesar eggs, so I need 12 little crisps. You can't believe how easy these are, and they just look so beautiful. Just little bitty things like this. You see how cute these little things are? You do want to flatten them just a tiny bit. I'm actually going to make a 15. I want to be sure that I have 12 beautiful Parmesan crisps. Look how cute these things are. Very carefully, I'm going to put these in my 375 degree oven. And these are only going to take a few minutes, so make sure you watch them careful. My Parmesan crisps are ready. Now really, they only take like 3 or 4 minutes. And I can't do anything with them now. We need to let them cool. They're very fragile. I don't want them to break. You don't want to mess with them as soon as they come out of the oven. Let them sit here for a little while, and then we'll be able to easily move them off the paper. To peel my eggs, I just bang them on the side of the sink, and I like to run them under cold water. And most often, they all peel pretty perfectly.
Hey, have you guys subscribed yet? If you haven't, please do. And make sure you stick around till the end of the video, because I'm making some very nice drinks.
I'm just slicing my eggs now. We're gonna do 6 whole eggs of each flavor. We're gonna start with the
Caesar eggs. To my six yolks in my bowl here, I'm gonna add about a quarter cup of mayo. I'm not measuring. I'll have all the measurements in the recipe that you can print. I've got a printable recipe. So about a quarter cup of mayo. We're gonna put in about 1 teaspoon of Dijon. Oh, I love that smell. We've got a little bit less than a quarter cup of Parmesan we're pouring in. I'm gonna use some lemon juice. Wow, that's a big one. Okay, probably about a tablespoon or two. And then we're gonna use 1 clove of garlic here. We're gonna smash it into here. Ooh, it smells good. Can you smell that, Ed?
Yes.
And of course, once I get this mixture mixed up, I'm gonna taste it. I'm gonna taste a tweak. So I'm gonna use, you could use a fork if you want to. It'd take a little bit longer to mash it up. I'm gonna use my hand mixer with the whisk on here. Let's give this a good stir. We're just gonna add a little bit of salt and pepper. And then we're gonna give this another good mix. I do have to say that using the hand mixer makes the mixture nice and fluffy. You can't get that with the fork. I'm just gonna taste it to see if we need anything else in here. Ooh, ooh, that's good. Let me show you how we're gonna pipe this into the half eggs now. You don't need any piping bag. Let me show you how. So I don't really have any piping bags. What I do is I take a tall glass, I take a plastic bag, and I push this into the glass like this. Fold it over on the sides. And then I'm just gonna take this egg mixture, the yolk mixture, and put it right into my glass here until I've got it all in there. What I'm doing now is I'm just gonna take my bag out of the glass. I'm gonna push my mixture down into the bag. And then I'm gonna twist it just like a piping bag. Just like that. And then I'm gonna cut the little corner off here. And now, whoops, we'll be able to pipe it right into the eggs here. Just like that. Beautiful, yeah?
Very nice.
Yeah, you don't need a piping bag. Now that I'm ready for my Parmesan crisps, I'm just making sure each one of them is moving easily on the paper here. Look at how gorgeous those are. Just beautiful. These eggs are getting more and more gorgeous as we go. Now that I've got all my Parmesan crisps nice and loose, look at that. I'm just gonna put one into each egg. Have you seen anything this gorgeous? What do you think, Eddie?
It's like in a restaurant, honey.
It's beautiful, isn't it? Just gorgeous. And I made a couple extra so we can munch on those, honey. Look at that. Now that those Caesar eggs are looking fantastic, let's work on the Bloody Mary deviled eggs. So I put my 6 yolks into my bowl. I'm gonna use just about 1 teaspoon of tomato paste in here. That's about 1 teaspoon. I'm gonna use about 1/4 cup of mayo, just like that. I'm going to use about 1 teaspoon of horseradish. About 1 teaspoon of horseradish. I love horseradish, that smells so good. We're gonna add a little bit of celery salt. Again, all the measurements will be on the recipe that I post with this video. Celery seed. I'm gonna use the juice of about 1/2 of a lemon, like that. Let's put a little salt and pepper in here. Do you guys love Bloody Marys? I love them with the veggies, with the celery, with the pickles. They're wonderful. A little pepper. Let's give this a good mix, and then we're gonna taste it to tweak. I'm just gonna give this a taste to see if I need to add anything. Always make sure you taste to tweak. Make it your own. Ooh, I love Bloody Marys, and this is really reminding me. I can taste the celery in the background. It's nice and salty, and I do think it could use a little bit more
tomato paste and maybe just a touch more salt. And we're gonna give this a good mix and then we'll pipe those eggs. It's time to put these Bloody Mary eggs together. Watch what I'm gonna do here. I said this was gonna be fancy. We've got Old Bay seasoning here on this plate. I'm gonna take each egg and do that. Look at how gorgeous that is. So I'm gonna do that to all 12 eggs. Oh man, beautiful. So just like I did with the other mixture, I'm just putting in my yolk mixture into my bag inside the glass here. Whoop, escapee. Let me get that. There we go. Take my bag out. Push the mixture down into a corner. I'm trying to get the air out of there too, so you won't have bubbles coming out of here. Just like that. And I'm twisting it just like a piping bag. Cutting off the tip. And I'm gonna go fill my eggs. Look at that. Ooh, beautiful. Friends, these Bloody Mary deviled eggs are gonna remind you so much of a Bloody Mary drink. I cut some little pickles here. I'm gonna push into each one. And I also have these little cute celery leaves. And with a toothpick, I'm just gonna press that into the egg mixture. Look at that. Oh my gosh. These are so beautiful. What do you think, Ed?
Just like in a restaurant.
Oh my gosh. Look at how cute that looks. So I'm gonna do all the rest of my eggs here. And then you know what it's time for, Ed?
Our famous ocean blue drink.
Yes, ocean blue. You guys are gonna love the drink coming up, so stay tuned. Don't go away. We are so ready to eat these beautiful deviled eggs. All we need is the drink now. What are you making, Ed?
I am making ocean blue.
Okay, to start, all you need is a couple of short glasses with ice. Put one shot of rum chata in each, honey.
Okay, will do.
Here's what's next, Ed. Put in a jigger of the blue curacao.
Oh, will do. There's the blue part of ocean blue.
It's gorgeous, isn't it?
Yes.
Next, we need a shot and a half of the black cherry rum. Mm-hmm. One of my favorites. Yum.
One and a half, going in.
All right, now we need two shots of the pineapple juice.
Two shots of the pineapple
Yeah.
juice coming
out. Oh, my favorite. I do love that too. This is kind of a take on a drink that we get out at a restaurant. We came home and we duplicated it. We made it our own.
Yeah, we did. It's delicious.
It's so good. Then just add a good couple of squirts of that lime juice, hon.
Okay.
That's great. Now give that baby a good shake.
Oh yeah.
Shake it up, baby. It's party time. 150 videos, can you believe it?
Okay, I'm gonna put the finishing touch on this and pour it into the carafes. Oh, look at that pretty color blue.
It looks like the ocean, doesn't it? Just beautiful. Love it. Now all that's left to do is mix those babies.
You ready, honey?
Yes. Let's see how that looks. Ooh, that is gorgeous. I'll take that one.
Oh, yeah.
Ooh, thank you, hon. Get yours ready.
Oh, yeah.
Let's take a sip together. Cheers to 150 videos, hon.
Yes.
Thank you for your help. All right. We're at the end of our 150th video. Here's to 150 more, honey.
Wow, I can't believe it. 150. Wow.
We've really had a lot of fun doing this. Yeah. I hope you guys are enjoying it as much as we're enjoying making these.
Yeah.
Cheers, honey. That is delicious.
Is that pretty or what? I'll tell you what, it tastes even better than it looks.
It's gorgeous. I'm gonna try one of these Bloody Mary deviled eggs.
Yeah, me too.
Let's see. Ooh, yeah. Mmm. Mmm. All that's missing is the vodka.
Mmm.
Oh my gosh, that's delicious. What do you think?
Yeah. Tastes like a Bloody Mary. Mmm. Like it should.
All the ambiance of a Bloody Mary. This is fantastic. One more bite here. Mmm. 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 Now we're going to move on to the Caesar.
Mm.
You go ahead and try it when you're ready, hon. I'm going to have one more sip of drink here. Hey, if you guys have not subscribed yet, please make sure you do. And share my videos with your friends, because if you like them, you know your friends will too. So if you're looking for deviled eggs to impress, these are it. I hope you enjoy making these. I hope you enjoy watching us today. And remember, you eat with your eyes first. You have got to make it beautiful. We'll see you next time. Bye-bye.